Guys, my name is Muhammad and welcome to episode 2 of HTML tutorial series. In this tutorial, we are going to go deep into HTML, and that is the header tag and their paragraphs. So in this header tag, as you can see, we define this is a cool page, but what if you want to define a lot of paragraphs? You can use the paragraph tag to define that kind of things. So we'll just copy this and paste it again. So we will decide, say, like, I love this video. And subscribe. Spell subscribe, you know, so subscribe and click on the like button, so you have to be sorry because I don't know how to type very fast. So we are going to save this guy and then run it. So we have our HTML for beginners. When we run it, you will see that these guys have added a lot of things. I love this video. Subscribe, click on the like button. So this is used to create a lot of paragraphs on a page. Every page in the world or every website uses this paragraph frequently to create that kind of paragraphs. And then page. So we have put this header in our page. So what if we want to make the header a lot smaller? So we will use the H2 opening tag, H2 then closing tag of the H2. So we also have the history, we have the H4, H4, H5, H5, and H6. So the smaller the letter or the smaller the number, the bigger the text within the header is. So H6 will definitely be so small, and H5 will be bigger than H6, and H4 will be bigger than H5. This is how it is done. So H1 will be the biggest, because the smaller the number, the bigger the text will be. So we will just add this guy into them so that we will be able to view it. This guy. So as you can see, we have starting head HTML, starting HTML, starting HTML. All it's getting smaller and smaller and smaller when we define. So when we change the number of in the head. So we have this kind of guy right here. So every HTML page usually used to centralize it headers. So what if we want to centralize this H1 in our page? We use the align inside. We use the align center. So this align center is should be inside H1. If you want what has been written right here to be centralized, you have to use this align center right here, make this centralized. So this is equals to align is equals to center. That means that this page or this state is statin HTML will be centralized. So only the statin HTML will be centralized because this guy right here is within the H1, and the H1 is already closed by this guy right here, H1, closing tag. So this outline will centralize the page, and we will see how it is done. So as you can see, when we save this, I haven't saved it, right? When we save this guy right here, and then we view it. Oh my god, I hate this kind of thing. Okay, as you can see, this statin HTML is being centralized in the page. So when you want to centralize a text in a page, you use the align center. Align is equals to center. What if you want it to be on the left side of the page? So we use left. What if we want it to be on the right? We use right, right? Right on the right, left on the left side of the page. Let's test this right. Okay. So we will save this guy right here and then test it. As you can see, it has gone all the way through to the right side of the page. Okay, so this align right is very, very important when you want to align your text to the right side of the page. So this is all about headers and paragraphs. If you like this video, click on the like button. If you didn't subscribe, you should definitely subscribe. Otherwise, stay tuned for my next episode.